morning to you all. So in this episode of another online class, today I will be discussing you physical properties of amine. And basically, I will be today elaborating about the basicity of amines. So you all know that amine, they are derivative of ammonia. So when you replace one or more hydrogen atom of ammonia with alkyl or aryl group, then the resulting compound is called amine. So similar to ammonia, amine has nitrogen atom with lone pair electron. So it behaves as a Lewis base. So Lewis base are species which have at least one unshared electron pair over an atom and can accept a proton. They are called Lewis base. And Lewis base are species which can donate at least one non-bonding electron pair to form a covalent bond with some other electron deficient species. So amines, they have nitrogen atom with lone pair electron, and this lone pair electron can be donated to electron deficient species. So they behave as a base, and the term we use Lewis base. And the strength of the base will depend upon two factors: the availability of lone pair electron over nitrogen, or the electron density over nitrogen atom. So higher electron density means more easily electron pair can be donated. Then secondly, more importantly, the ammonium ion so formed in case of amine, or in case of aniline, the inilium ion so formed, because once the nitrogen atom get protonated, the nitrogen atom turn into the quaternary state. So for aliphatic amine, we will get a substituted ammonium ion, and for aromatic amine, we will get an inilium ion. And the basic strength will depend upon the stability of the ammonium ion or the inilium ion. So now what I will do, I will just present a PowerPoint which I made for you. And if required, I will also go to the board. So here is my PowerPoint. So this is the PowerPoint, amines. Nomenclature part yesterday I discussed. Today I'll be discussing the physical property, special emphasis to basicity of amine. So here I go. I will discuss physical property with emphasis on basicity of amine. So I will just forward the slides. Okay, basicity of amine. The lone pair electron on nitrogen atom makes amine basic and nucleophile. So amines, they can donate a pair of electron through nitrogen atom. So they are called Lewis base. And they're also nucleophilic in nature. They can also behave as nucleophile, because Lewis base and nucleophile, same meaning, ability to donate a pair of electron. So to become a base, Lewis base, you need to have a pair of unshared electron pair. And to become a nucleophile also, there should be at least one unpaired electron pair. Then amines, because they are basic in nature, they react with acid to form acid-base salt. So this is an amine, nitrogen atom with lone pair electron, and this is an acid. And this nitrogen atom get protonated, you will get this and substituted ammonium ion and this anion, and they will together form a salt. Amine are stronger based than alcohol, ether, or water. Why? Because in amine, the lone pair electron is present over nitrogen, whereas in alcohol, the lone pair electron is present over oxygen atom. So nitrogen atom is less electronegative than oxygen. So the lone pair electron over oxygen in alcohol or ether cannot be easily donated because of higher electronegativity of oxygen. Then amine establishes an equilibrium with water in which amine becomes protonated and hydroxide ion is produced. So when you dissolve amine in water, then what will happen? Amine will accept proton from water, and consequently, the solution will become rich in hydroxide ion. The most convenient way to measure the basicity of an amine is to look the acidity of the corresponding ammonium ion. Higher pKa, weaker acid, and stronger base. So sometimes my student used to puzzle that Ka and pKa, it is used to measure acidity of acid. Higher Ka, stronger acid, lower pKa, stronger acid. But how do you measure the basicity in terms of Ka and pKa? So you know, every base have a conjugate acid. Strong base will have weak conjugate acid, and weak base will have strong conjugate acid. So if the base is strong, the conjugate acid will be weaker. And weaker conjugate acid means low pKa and higher pKa. So when Ka becomes lower, pKa will become higher. So high pKa, weak acid, and stronger conjugate base. So here, how do we calculate Kb and pKb, Ka? So this is an amine. This is an amine. It reacts with water to give an alkyl ammonium ion and hydroxide. And there will be a dynamic equilibrium between them. So Kb can be defined as the concentration of alkyl ammonium ion, concentration of hydroxide ion, concentration of amine. So here water term is not appearing because water is used in excess. And we assume that the concentration of water remains constant because it is in excess. So here it is clear. A strong base means it will produce more hydroxide ion, and it will have high Kb value. And pKb is the negative logarithm of Kb. So high Kb means lower pKb. So strong base will have high Kb and low pKb. Now this is the amine, and this is its conjugate acid. So if the amine is strong, the conjugate acid will become weak. So you remember in our previous classes that strong acid, weak conjugate base, strong base, weak conjugate acid. So if the base is strong, the conjugate acid will be weaker. And weaker conjugate acid means low Ka and higher pKa. So here I measure the acidity of the conjugate acid. RnH3 plus plus H2O. So this is a conjugate acid. It will donate a proton. And H2O, it will be converted to H3O plus. So this is not minus. This one will be plus. Now applying the law of mass action, here again the water term is not coming because water is in excess. So here, this is the value of Ka, and the negative logarithm of Ka is called pKa. So a strong base will have weak conjugate acid, means low Ka and weak and high pKa. So here are some amine. So this is ammonia. So these are all pKa value. So here this is ammonia. And ammonia pKa is 9.25. And these are methylamine, methanamine. This is N-methyl methanamine. This is a secondary amine. This is a tertiary amine. And the alkyl groups are nitrogen. So here, these alkyl amines are more basic than ammonia. That you can easily explain on the basis of plus I effect of alkyl group. So alkyl group is electron pushing group. It pushes electron, and as a result, electron density over nitrogen increases than that is in ammonia. So here are two alkyl group, there will be more plus I effect, there are three alkyl group. But what we expect, that as the number of alkyl group increases, the basicity should increase. So here, out of this primary, secondary, and tertiary amine, what you observe? Primary amine 10.64 pKa. This one is 10.77 and this one is 9.8. So the three amine is more basic than ammonia. But out of primary, secondary, and tertiary, we expect tertiary amine to be more basic. But what we observe, actually observe, that secondary amine is more basic than primary and tertiary amine. So the pKa value is reflecting that out of this three amine, the secondary amine is having the highest pKa value. So it is the strongest base. And lowest is the tertiary amine. And in between, you have primary amine. Now, what is the reason? Because I have already told you. So this is just a dissociation. This is a reaction of ammonia in water. So for the equilibrium to be shifted to the right, this space must be stable. Similar to when we studied in the previous classes, strength of acid depends upon its ability to donate proton and also upon the strength of the conjugate base, that is the anion. So in case of a base, the strength depends upon the electron density over nitrogen. So high electron density means easily electron pair can be donated. So stronger will be the base. And also upon the stability of the conjugate acid. Because if the conjugate acid is not stable, then the reverse reaction will occur. So strength of a base will depend upon its ability to donate a pair of electrons to electron deficient space C, and also upon the stability of the conjugate acid. So relative strength, ammonia. So I have already told you that alkyl amines are more basic than ammonia. This is because of plus I effect of alkyl group, which is increasing electron density over nitrogen. Now the question is, do we expect electron density over nitrogen to increase as I move from primary to secondary, then secondary to tertiary? So this is fine. Secondary amine is more basic than primary amine. But what about tertiary amine? It is least basic of the amine. Its basicity is less than primary amine. So this we can explain on the basis of the conjugate ammonia ion. So here I can explain it. So here you can see the pictures. So this is the primary amine. This is the secondary amine. This is the primary amine. This is a secondary amine. And this is a tertiary amine. So here primary amine, nitrogen atom, is feeling the plus I effect of one alkyl group. So alkyl group is pushing electron. So nitrogen atom becoming mutually electron. So electron density will be higher. Then in secondary amine, there are two alkyl groups pushing electron toward nitrogen. So electron density over here is higher than here. And the highest electron density is in tertiary amine. So this is my tertiary amine. This is the tertiary amine. So there are three alkyl groups. These are the three alkyl groups. They are pushing electron toward nitrogen. So electron density is highest over nitrogen. So electron density increases as I move from primary to tertiary. So we didn't expect that tertiary amine should be most basic
among the primary, secondary, and tertiary. Now, what happens? Let us see. Amine, it accepts proton, and you get this style of aluminium. Can you see? This is R, NH2, one more NH1 form. So, how many hydrogen bonds are, how many NH bonds are there? 1, 2, 3. And this 3 NH bond can form intermolecular hydrogen bonding with water and get stabilized. So, in water, what happens? The trialkyl aluminium ion through the NH bond will form intermolecular hydrogen bonding with water and get stabilized. So, the ammonium ion from primary amine, it has 3 NH bond, and this NH bond can form hydrogen bond with water. But for secondary amine, you see, there are only 2 NH bond. This is 1 NH bond and this is 1 NH. In primary, there were 3 NH bonds. 1, 2, 3. So here the degree of hydration will be less than primary amine, because the degree of hydration will depend upon the number of NH bonds. More number of NH bonds, there will be more intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Then in trialkyl amine, this is the tertiary amine, it gets protonated. And in the trialkyl aluminium ion, there is only 1 NH bond. So it forms only 1 hydrogen bond with water. So here, reverse thing happens. As I move from top to bottom, electron density increases over nitrogen. But as I move from primary amine to tertiary amine, the stability of their conjugate acid decreases. Because as I move from primary to tertiary amine, the number of NH bond get lowered. So degree of hydrogen bonding get lowered. So this one is most unstable. This one is most unstable in terms of stability of the conjugate acid, and this is most stable. So both the effect are in opposite way. Plus I effect is increasing electron density over nitrogen, and we expect tertiary amine to be more basic. Whereas the stability of the conjugate acid decreases as I move from primary to tertiary due to decrease in degree of hydrogen bonding, due to decrease in number of NH bonds. So as a result, what happens? Secondary amine wins the race. It wins the race. So secondary amine is more basic than primary and tertiary. So, if you compare the basicity of primary, secondary, and tertiary amine, then tertiary amine is less basic because the conjugate acid is dehydrated and this is stable. And secondary amine is most basic. Why? Because the stability of the intermediate cation is also good. There are 3 NH bonds forming, 2 NH bonds forming intermolecular hydrogen bonding. And also electron density of nitrogen is also higher due to plus I effect of 2 alkyl. I hope I'm able to clear your doubt regarding the basicity of amine. So again, I will be moving into the power. So here we can easily explain the basicity of higher basicity of secondary amine in terms of stability of the conjugate acid. So here Kb value, again the Kb value, you see aliphatic amine 10 to the power of minus 3, 10 to the power of minus 4. This is high. Ammonia 1.8 into 10 to the power of minus 5. And aniline, aromatic amine, it is very, very less basic. So why aliphatic amines are more basic than ammonia? Already have discussed. The alkyl group R is an electron donating group. The donation of electron helps to stabilize the ammonium ion by decreasing the positive charge, lowering delta S, shifting the ionization further to the right, and increasing the basicity. So the plus I effect of alkyl group also stabilizes this positive charge, and also this NH bond undergoes hydrogen bonding. More NH bond, more intermolecular hydrogen bonding, more will be the stability.
Now, what about aromatic amide? So here again, this is aniline. It reacts with water to give anilium ion plus hydroxide ion. But in case of aromatic amide, what happens? This positive charge does not get stabilized. This positive charge does not get stabilized. So aniline is less basic than ammonia. And moreover, in aniline, what happens? You see, the lone pair electron of a nitrogen get involved in resonance. The lone pair electron of a nitrogen get involved in resonance. So these are the blue canonical structures for what? For aniline. 1, 2. So here you are having a nitrogen lone pair electron. It is getting involved in resonance. And as a result, what you find? That nitrogen atom is becoming positively charged, means electron density over nitrogen is decreasing. Now, what is the effect of substituent upon basicity of aromatic amine? Electron donating group will stabilize the iridium ion. So if you have an electron donating group G, suppose G donates electron, it pumps electron into the benzene ring. As a result, the positive charge over nitrogen in the conjugate acid will get stabilized. And on the other hand, if there's an electron withdrawing group, if you have an electron withdrawing group, then what will happen? It will withdraw electron from benzene ring, and this positive charge over nitrogen will get more destabilized. So repeatedly, I'm telling you that the strength of a base depends upon not only its ability to donate proton, but also upon the stability of the conjugate acid. So any group which will stabilize the positive charge in the conjugate acid will increase basicity, and any group which destabilizes the positive charge over the conjugate acid will lower basicity. So these are electron donating group. You already know electron donating group, amino group, these are a hydroxy group, alkoxy group, etc., etc. They can donate electron. Hydrogen can neither donate electron nor can withdraw electron. So relative to hydrogen, they are electron donating, and these groups are electron withdrawing. So presence of these groups in the aromatic ring will increase the basicity of aniline, and presence of this group will decrease the basicity of aniline. So now this is a problem. Number the following in decreasing order of the base strength. For most basic, it is 1. So which one is more basic, most basic? Anyone can tell me? Sabat koi basic kuntu, which one is most basic? Kuntu sabat ko basic ya vitart sabat ko basic strength yes
4
yes 1 2 3 4 5 number 1 kuntu hobo sabat ko basic etu jodi 1 boli dhoru this is 2 this is 3 this is 4 this is 5 number so most basic kuntu likhim 1 kuntu likhim eketa khali jaga
most basic to number 4 to hobo niki
number 4 to no hoy a to hobo most basic dekhisa nai a to my aromatic nitrogen electron pair will be involved in resonance so aliphatic amines are more basic than aromatic amine it hole aliphatic amine in case of aromatic amine the lone pair electron get involved in resonance hai na is it clear so this one is most basic
yes, sir.
And these are all three are aromatic amine. And aromatic amine are less basic than ammonia, so this one will be 1, this one will be 2, this one will be 3, electron pushing group, 4, there is no electron pushing or electron withdrawing group, and this one will be 5. So let me see. So can you understand the sequence?
Yes, sir.
So this is what I tried to explain regarding basicity of amine. So the summary is, amine are basic in nature because nitrogen atom carries lone pair electron, which it can donate to electron deficient species. So amines are Lewis base. Then secondly, the basic strength can be measured in terms of pKa. pKa, higher pKa, stronger will be the base. Thirdly, aliphatic amines are more basic than ammonia, because in aliphatic amine, we have alkyl group over nitrogen that pushes electron over to nitrogen and increases electron density. Aromatic amines are less basic than ammonia, because in aromatic amine, the lone pair electron get involved in resonance. Then we have seen that in case of aromatic amine, electron withdrawing substituent will further decrease basicity, because electron withdrawing substituents will destabilize the positive charge over nitrogen in the conjugate acid. An electron releasing group will stabilize the positive charge over nitrogen in the conjugate acid. So I hope you understand this class. So this is one of the most important properties of amine. That is the basic property of amine. I hope I could explain you.